Good evening, friends, and welcome back to the Rainbow Ballroom. I'm Tom Dendy, pastor of Celebration Presbyterian Church, and we're located in the heart of the Carolina Forest community of Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. Since way back in 2020, early in the days of the pandemic, when we couldn't get together, we had to be creative, and we came up with this as a way of having church, getting together between Sundays remotely. So we call it Tuesday Evening Virtual Vespers, and we come together from across the airwaves for prayer and scripture, some songs, and some updates on information, and just a chance to get together. So welcome. Come on in the house. Send a shout out to my friend Paul Clements, who was with me in the Rainbow Ballroom last Tuesday evening. He was the first guest musician to join me, and it was truly a joyous occasion as we made some joyful noise unto the Lord. He has moved on to Boston, and he is helping his middle son, Aaron, and visiting with them and his granddaughter, and he's working on a woodshed project, helping his son build a woodshed. So prayers for him. We also send a word out to all those who have been storm affected by Helene and who are suffering right now. And they're not seeing this because of lack of cellular and lack of power and lack of water and other things. But we're going to lift them up in our time together and pray for them and for the recovery efforts and the first responders and the utility workers, all of whom are pressed into high gear out there trying to make a difference. So come on in. Let's gather together. I saw signs of life there just a second, but I didn't see a name. Thank you, Bernadine, if you're there sharing the love over to Celebration. Well, our first song, our gathering song, our theme for tonight, I didn't say that yet. Our theme is serving with Jesus and responding to his call with "Here I am, Lord." I know that's a favorite for many of you. And we're going to sing some service-related hymns and songs. This first song is called "Come Live in the Light," subtitle "We Are Called."
Sing a new
the first day of October, and we're here in the Rainbow Ballroom for Tuesday Evening Virtual Vespers. And our theme for tonight is serving with Jesus, and our response being, "Here I am, Lord." Our scripture, which we'll get to in just a little bit, is from Mark chapter 10. I'll give you the specifics just a little bit. But hear this call to worship. It's good to be together, God on these screens with these people together, listening for your voice, united by your spirit. And in this time of worship, tell us about your kingdom of kindness so that we can seek it. Show us your justice. We want to walk with you humbly, closely, daily. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. This next song is called "More About Jesus." God, we're in awe of your magnificent power displayed through the entire universe. For through you all things were made and all things have their being. We come before you with grateful thanks and with hearts that long to adore you and worship only you. Lord, may we know the presence of the Holy Spirit with us today. May we be open to your leading, sensitive to your speaking, and alert to your calling. Father, we invite the same power that was at work when Jesus was raised from the grave to be present with us here now. Lord, we declare that you are welcome here among us. In Jesus' name, amen. So our scripture comes from Mark 10th chapter, and it's verses 42 to 45. I invite you to listen. Hello. Hello, Carol Mitchell and Sue Barkley. Welcome. Hear the word of God from Mark 10, 42 to 45. So Jesus called them and said to them, he's talking to his disciples, you know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it's not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant. And whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many. Friends, this is God's word for God's people. And we say thanks be to God. Well, it's been a horrific past week or so, and especially devastating to so many folks in the Carolinas and Florida and Georgia and all along the way where Helene has passed. So let's offer a prayer. This is a prayer by grief counselor Lisa Haynes for those victims of Helene. Sending love and prayers for all those impacted by Hurricane Helene. Heavenly Father, our hearts are broken for the families and communities forever changed by Helene. Praying for all those impacted by Hurricane Helene from Florida, Georgia, Tennessee, South Carolina, and North Carolina. In these overwhelming moments of loss and devastation, we come to you asking for your loving care and provision amidst those who are greatly suffering from tremendous loss of lives and homes and communities. Life as they have known it has been shattered. We pray for the safety of the first responders and all those who are assisting in the recovery. Protect and guide all who serve as rescue workers in their recovery efforts. We pray for all those who are in need of emergency aid, that they'll receive essential assistance swiftly and the restoration of communications and power and water as soon as possible throughout the region. Lord, we know you're able, and we ask you, protect folks in Jesus' name. Amen. This next hymn, called as Partners in Christ's Service. Well, called as partners in Christ's service, called to ministries of grace, we respond with deep commitment, fresh new lines of faith to trace. May we learn the art of sharing side by side and friend with friend, equal partners in our caring to fulfill God's chosen. Christ inspiring, Christ clear call to work and worth. Let us follow, never faltering, reconciling folks on earth, men and women, richer, poorer, all God's people, young and old, blending human skills together, gracious gifts from Well, thus new patterns for Christ's mission, in a small or global sense, help us bear each other's burdens, breaking down each wall or fence. Words of comfort, words of vision, words of challenge said with care, bring new power and strength for action. Make us colleagues free and fair. So God grant us for tomorrow ways to order human life that surround each person's sorrow with a calm that conquers strife. Make us partners in our living, our compassion to increase, messengers of faith us giving hope and confidence and peace. Hope and confidence and peace.
Well, I've shared with you before over the years that this concept for Tuesday Evening Vespers, not the virtual part, but Vespers in general, was drawn from my summer church camp experiences growing up in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Virginia, in the Abingdon Presbyterian, going to the Abingdon Presbytery church camp. Each evening around dusk, we campers would make our way to an area that was called Vesper Dell, and it had log benches and a fire pit and a rustic pulpit. And we'd gather there as daylight was fading in the west, and somebody with a guitar would lead us as we sang songs together, and then we'd pray together. And we'd stare at the stars together and hear Bible stories and testimonies, encouraging devotions shared by either a camp director or a visiting pastor who was there in residence. And it was in that summer night sky setting of outdoor worship that I first felt the call of God stirring in my life. First, a deep sense that I was loved by God, and second, a sense that God had a purpose and a plan for my life, and it was a plan that would benefit me and would ultimately glorify God. So the seeds of call sown in my heart way back a long time ago in summer camp Vespers continues to grow, and I'm still feeling the deep roots of my calling today, stemming from way back on those moonlit Vesper nights in the mountains of Virginia. It was also at Vespers where I heard stories of missionaries and disciples called to serve with Jesus in all kinds of different ways, in places both far and near. The point was clearly made that God had a plan for each of our lives, and we were to serve God in our churches and homes and communities, and even around the world. So Jesus never intended a power play to start, some kind of new world order that would be his kingdom. It wasn't going to be built on military might or lording over people, as he told his disciples. What he said was, you're called to be the servants of all, and that he was demonstrating that kind of service in and through his own life and ultimately through his death and resurrection as well. Jesus' kingdom was a kingdom not of upward mobility, but downward mobility, led by a Savior who lived simply, with no particular place to call home. He humbled himself and he served his followers. He washed his disciples' dirty feet on the night of his arrest. He fed them, washed their feet, prepared them for his leaving them. And he charged them, saying in essence, after he had washed their feet, Inasmuch as you've seen me do this for you, you now go and do it in turn for others. Serve one another as I, your master, have served you." Let's pray again. Lord, thank you for letting us work with you to share your joy with the world. Help us not take for granted the gift it is to share your gospel to the nations and to our neighbors. Help us to have eyes to see the needs around us and to respond to those needs in joy and hope. Thank you so much, Lord, for your love and care over us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I want to dedicate this next song to Carol Mitchell, who was the first one whose name showed up tonight, but even more importantly, I know she's told me this song is her song. Here I am, Lord. I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light for them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of snow and rain, I have borne my people's pain. I have wept for love of them. They turn away. I will break their hearts of stone, give them hearts for love alone. I will speak my word to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard if you lead me, I will hold your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. Finest bread I will provide till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart. welcome, Bruce Watson. Come in the house. Few reminders this busy week, things going on. October 3rd, Thursday, men's luncheon is at the Claw House Restaurant in Merle's Inlet at 11:30 a.m. Also on Thursday, the 3rd, Ladybug Luncheon is at Wahoo Fish House in Merle's Inlet at 11:30 a.m. Friday, October 4th is bingo at the church in the sanctuary at 2 p.m. Saturday, October 5th, it's the first Saturday Bible study on the Book of Romans. That's at 10 a.m. Saturday morning. And Sunday, October 6th, it's World Communion Sunday. So whether you'll be with us in person or joining us remotely, we ask you to prepare for communion this Sunday. Whether you're at home or whether you're with us at church, we're going to celebrate communion, and we hope you'll celebrate with us. We encourage you to check your email. If you're on our email list, we send out a Tuesday and Thursday email, just two. And the Tuesday focuses on activities coming up in the life of the church, and Thursday focuses on the order of worship for the coming Sunday and includes the hymns and everything you need to know to participate fully from wherever you might be. If you're not on our list and you would like to be, you can phone the church office at 843-903-0308. And Irma Stackhouse will be glad to add your email to the list. Or if you want to text me and tell me to add your email address, give it to me and I'll pass it along. We'll add you in. Also, if you'd like to support this ministry of celebration monetarily, you can do so by going to the website celebrationpresbyterianchurch.org, all lowercase, celebrationpresbyterianchurch.org. There you can choose the Donate Now tab or link, and it will allow you to make a secure online gift. Thank you again for coming out tonight and participating. Thank you for your support throughout the pandemic and right up until now. I encourage you, as I have from the start, to keep on doing the best you can, to do the best you can and be the best you can be day by day. Make the difference that you can make for positivity and change for the good of all in the world, one day at a time. Now hear this word of benediction. We've been called to serve the Lord with gladness. Go from this place knowing that God's blessings have been poured on you and into you so that you in turn may be a blessing for others and with others. Be at peace and bring the good news of God's love and peace to all whom you meet. In Jesus' name we bless that and send you with it. Saying amen. This next song is a two-pager. I got to reposition here just a little bit to see it all. It's called Today We All Are Called to Be Disciples. Today we all are called to be disciples of the Lord, to help to set the captives free, make plowshares out of sword, to feed the hungry, quench their thirst, make love and peace our fast, to serve the poor and homeless first, our ease and comfort last. Birth ordained our human race to live as stewards of the earth, responding to God's grace. But we are vain and sadly proud, we sow not peace but strife. Our discord spreads a deadly cloud that threatens all of life.
with righteousness in field and town, to cleanse us and redeem. For God is longing to restore an earth where conflicts cease, a world that was created for a harmony of peace. May we in service to our God act out the living word and walk the road the saints have trod till all have seen and heard. As stewards of the earth, may we give thanks in one accord to God who calls us all to be disciples of the Lord.
Today we all were called to be disciples of the Lord. Well, I want to thank you for coming out again tonight and for sharing Vespers together. And I just want to remind you that God loves you one and all, and so do we at Celebration Presbyterian Church. Let's see. I got one more song. It's called Won't You Let Me Be Your Servant.
Won't you let me be your servant? Let me be as Christ to you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too. We are pilgrims on a journey. We are brothers on the road. We are here to help each other walk the mile and bear the load. I will hold the Christ light for you in the night time of your fear. I will to you speak the peace you long to hear. I will weep when you are weeping. When you laugh, I'll laugh with you. I will share your joy and sorrow till we've seen this journey through. When we sing to God in heaven, we shall find such harmony. Born of all we've known together, of Christ's love and agony. Won't you let me be your servant? Let me be as Christ to you. Pray that I may have the grace to let you be my servant too.
Well, friends, again, it's been great to be with you as we have thought about what it means to serve alongside Jesus in light of all the damage around us from the recent hurricane. There's going to be plenty of opportunities to serve our brothers and sisters in a whole host of ways. So let's be creative and let's be part of the recovery effort in whatever way we can to contribute to the rebuilding that'll go on and on and on for months and months, and maybe even years in some cases. Thank you again for coming out, and God bless you real good. Until we meet again.